Hello, my lovely anatomist. Welcome back to our topic of lymphatic system. And today's video is all about lymphoid tissue, so lymph nodules. So let us get started. All right, y'all. So what we are looking at right here is our lymph nodule. So here we can think about this more as a collection of lymphocytes. And the key thing is that it is not surrounded by a capsule. So it's not something that could be maybe easily dissected and cut out from surrounding tissue. That's what we're looking at right here. So they've outlined in white, but I think really this particular area is what we are talking about when we say our lymph nodule. And what we can see with this line here in the center is what is called the germinal center. And this is where you have lots of dividing lymphocytes. And here we should think dividing lymphocytes. These are our T cells. Remember our cytotoxic T cells and our B cells, which ultimately become plasma cells and produce our antibodies or immunoglobulins. Now the lymph nodules are actually one of the stars of the lymphatic system. And we already mentioned the MALT in a previous video, looking at mucosa-associated lymphoid tissue. So that's talking about the mucosal lining. Anywhere that mucosal lining is present, you're going to see lymphoid nodules. So again, think in terms of these are passageways of the body where foreign material has potential access. So the entire lining of the digestive tract needs to have these lymphoid tissues because clearly you're bringing in food, water, and pathogens along with that. You have gut-associated lymphoid tissue, so this is going to be more associated with the small and large intestine. You have the bronchus-associated lymphoid tissue. So again, when we're talking about our respiratory tract, you're inhaling not just oxygen, but as well as pathogens and debris. And in the nasal cavity, you have the nasal associated lymphoid tissue. So again, you have this whole collection of these lymphocytes without capsules, pretty much lining your organs, especially those locations where you have foreign material that you're actively bringing in. As we take a look here, what we're focusing in on in this particular image are your tonsils. Now, your tonsils are large lymphoid nodules. And they're located in your pharynx, which makes sense because both your respiratory system and your digestive system share this particular structure. And so we know that when we're inhaling or eating food and water, we're bringing in quite a few pathogens. We will see you have a singular pharyngeal tonsil, which can also be referred to as an adenoid. So if you've heard that term before. And then down here, these tonsils are in pairs. So you're going to have two palatine, although we're just seeing one in the diagram. And you're going to have two lingual, although again, we're just seeing one in the diagram. So you have five total tonsils. And this blown up picture over here, all of these sort of clear, circular, obvious to pick out places that we're seeing, those are the germinal centers, which again are locations for dividing lymphocytes. And again, when we're talking about lymphocytes here, remember your T cells and your B cells. All right, that is all for this particular presentation. Stay tuned for our next video looking at lymphatic organs. And as always, take care of yourselves and each other.